crores and touched 4.3. The deposit, that is a growth of 16% year on year. Deposits have grown by 16%. Advances, again, 15%. CASA growth is 9%. And the RAM sector, which has been the, which has taken half the, it was half the engine for the bank, the other half being corporate. RAM sector grew by 58%. Now it has crossed 1 lakh crores. And within RAM, the retail growth has been 13%. Agriculture is very good at 25%. And MSME growth 15%, all this year on year. Coming to the income, again, total income has grown by 8%, the interest income by 12%, net interest income again 12%, domestic NIM has now is now at 3%, operating profit has seen a small dip of 2% year on year, but operating profit excluding the profit on sale of investments, which was a major contributor last year, that shows an increase of 8% adjusted to that figure. The net profit for the year is at 322 crores. The quarter on quarter also, interest income shows a growth of 11%, net interest income 8%, and the domestic NIM is at 3%, global is at 2.95%. Operating profit of this quarter, again quarter on quarter, 1245 crores. It's a growth of 7%. The main feature I'm sure everyone is looking for is the asset quality health. The gross NPA ratio has come down to 7.11%, which is a 26 bps fall from the last year and 35 bps decrease from the sequential quarter, that is the December 18 quarter. Similarly, net NPA has registered 6 bps reduction from year on year, that is at 3.75%, and a quarter by quarter reduction of 67 bps. The one more positive and very good positive is that the fresh slippages in the second half of this financial year have been coming down sequentially. For example, in the last quarter, that is this January to March, the fresh slippages have been 1,005 crores, which is compared to 2,250 crores in Q2 and about 1,670 crores in Q3. So this, I think, is a proof that the bank is getting has got the handle over the fresh slippages, which I believe is the main first step of improving asset quality. Capital adequacy ratio, again, it is 13.21 now. It was 12.55% last year and 12.67% in the December 18 quarter. Tier 1 is at 11.29%. Again, the bank has a pan-India presence and it is growing very well in all the areas that we are present. I wanted to draw attention to the to our strength in the five South Indian states, where a major portion and also a very strong portion of our business is coming from. So going forward, we would be leveraging that strength in a more pronounced manner. For example, the CD ratio in the southern states is 91% against the bank's overall CD ratio of 77%. Also, we have a very strong network and a very strong presence across all the five southern states and the union territory of Puducherry. We are the exclusive banker in the state of Tamil Nadu and UT of Puducherry for the government schemes, and this is lending us a lot of fillip in both opening the accounts and also handling all the direct benefit transfers and other credits that move into these accounts. Also, you are aware that Indian Bank is the proud sponsor of the Tamil Nadu Grama Bank that has come into on the 1st April 2019. This RRB is formed by the amalgamation of the Pandyan Grama Bank of Indian Overseas Bank and our own Pallavan Grama Bank. So this Tamil Nadu Grama Bank is the fifth largest bank in Tamil Nadu today, and it has about 630 branches and a business of 21,500 crores. So this is a proud addition to the Indian Bank family now. Our IT initiatives have been receiving good attention and also well-deserved awards. We have been recognized as the best bank in the public financial management system, which is again a Government of India initiative to direct the subsidy payments. And mobile banking transactions have seen a 4x fillip. It is the second highest, it has the second highest ATM transactions among PSBs and fifth among all banks. It is also the highest RuPay Platinum card issuer among all banks. The awards have been coming in, especially for the best bank in terms of all parameters for last year, and also the social banking excellence that we are proud to continue. Most of the best bank in the SHA bank linkage has been being awarded by the Government of Tamil Nadu, and this is the 10th consecutive year we are receiving that. We also have been receiving the Financial Literacy Best Performance Award from NABARD, and this has been coming in for more than, I think, 16 years or so. Apart from these, going forward also, we have some strategies and some measures that we are taking, which we will cover in the slides to come. Yes, please. So this is the, again, the same snapshot of the figures that I was speaking of. One thing I missed out was on the provision coverage ratio, which has gone up 145 basis points year on year to 65.72%. Gone over. You can see a secular increase, I mean an improvement all over, whether it's business or whether it's CASA and whether it is the RAM book. RAM as a percentage is now 58%. And even across population groups, if you take the rural, semi-urban, urban or metro, the increase has been quite substantial and quite significant. Strongly, if you see the kind of contribution the southern states are making to the bank, we would continue to leverage this strength and also try to replicate it across the country. Income last year, it actually grew by 8%. The provisions are there for, you know, the kind of, but in the fourth quarter, I think the rest of the, there were no, we are increased the provisions, so as to have a head. This quarter, there was the only account, I think, which these are two big groups. ILFS, there was a account which we mentioned last time also, which was running well. Even today it is running well. But since the resolution is yet to happen, that was also taken as a substandard account and provisions were made. So that was one account. The other one is a group where we have almost provided for the whole thing, but then there were a few accounts that were provided for as per the requirement of the RBI guidelines. But since the group is in news and there were a lot of negative developments around that, we thought it would be prudent to provide 100% on that accounts. So that is actually accelerated the provision on those accounts, which added up to about 220 crores, which was not initially planned in December. So there is nothing that has happened suddenly, but we have tried to provide for the future and avoid any fallout on account of the whatever happens on the resolution front of those accounts.
So is it right for me to understand this is just a one-off, like, you know, yes, during this particular quarter alone you will see the pressure of this 220 crore on these two accounts?
220, yes. There was a aging provision also on one of those accounts, which was another 200 crores, but basically, yes, this is a one-off thing, and it is a resolution in process, so we can't say that we won't receive anything in from the resolution of the asset. But I don't see going forward, of course, there are always accounts, there are always you, but I think we are well guarded and well provided and well in control of the asset quality. Pardon? CSR is very active. Indian Bank, I think, is one of the most active banks in CSR. And we have this theme around women, around children, and around the sustainability. So there are a lot of activities happening across the bank. And one of the recent ones was the launching of the campaign to donate a sanitary napkin vending machine and an incinerator to low-income schools. where the girls of adolescent age, they are there, or low-income colleges for girls, so that the hygiene and the health factor is awareness is brought in right at the beginning. That is only one of the initiatives which is being taken up by all the zones, but there are a plethora of such activities going on in Indian Bank all the time. We'll come out with a separate web link to all the CSR activities. Thank you. About 43% of the branches. So I think, and the business wise also, Tamil Nadu contributes a good portion, especially in the RAM sector, in the agriculture, MSME, in the retail, and also the corporate. So we are very strongly linked to the south, to the Tamil Nadu state, and that state is one of the good performing states in India, and it is in the top five of the ease of doing business also. So I think we are in for a good stint together. But it would have been very positive. Next quarter, not only next quarter, quarters to come. It won't be one off. It will be well sustained.
So what are the initiatives you have taken, as far as the recovery concerned, and what are the factors which helped you to address the slippages? Is it because your focus was in more on RAM, which led to your corporate book to dip, vice versa?
Corporate book has grown by 12%, for your information, 12 or even 14. See, it has almost been stable between 55 to 58 now, RAM. So this bank has always been strong on the RAM sector, as also the corporate. The slippages in corporate happened because of reasons you all know. And how recovery is improving is because NCLT accounts, we are following up. But other than NCLT also, we are working very strongly with each of those companies, with the other consortium members, with other players in the field to bring the accounts to bring the assets to a resolution. And the progress is seen. We also had an online OTS for the retail sector, for the RAM sector, and that also is paying off. It has been launched in January. So this is up to 10 lakhs, and now we are starting it up to 1 crore also. So these are the accounts of small value but high volume, spread across all the branches. So an online OTS system where the information flow passes from the branch to the zonal office very fast. This is working in favor of the bank, which is a very clean, transparent, and auditable software.
Numbers, what has been your NCLT recoveries and what is 1T OTS number recovery has been?
The NCLT one book account got settled. That is in the year.
But that was in second quarter.
Actually, in the case of two accounts which we are expecting that it will be settled, that is Bhushan Steel and Power and Alok, that didn't took place. Hopefully, we expect within the first half year of the current year, financial year, it will get settled. Had that been taken place, our
position would have been still better. 700-800 crores.
Yes. I think I lost you, so...
Hey, see, in the case of last year, one is Uttam got upgraded, recovery took place because of the remittances which we saved. Second is the Bhushan Steel got resolved. Now, and even Electra Steel. Whereas we are expecting Bhushan Steel and Power also, and Alok. That couldn't get resolved, even in the fourth quarter. So hopefully we expect in the first half year of the current financial, we'll be able to get it resolved also. And the focus will be more on the small loan accounts also. Right from this particular week onwards, we'll be having this recovery camps. Besides, we'll be going for Lok Adalats and OTS, so that more recovery will come. And whatever the accounts are written off, focus will also be on that to see that recovery comes.
Also, a mobile app has been launched for all our staff, where the top 10 recovery or what are the accounts due for recovery, these are being uploaded so that the branch manager himself can see it on his app and follow up. So this has been launched recently. We expect that all these initiatives will work. The awareness and the urge to improve the balance sheet is very much there across the bank. One other point I need to thank our employees through this forum is for the resounding success of the employee stock purchase scheme, which we have just closed, and it has been successfully implemented. So all the employees, almost all the employees, have a stake in the future of the bank. So I am sure this recovery will be part of their agenda too, which is always there, but it would receive more.
Any observations on the EPS behavior?
And the market value, there is a market difference. So the earnings would be better next year, and I think all the metrics would show up better next through the next quarter. Yeah, that again is for all the reasons that we have mentioned just now. This would be a one-off thing this year, but it is a bargain we had to strike, and I think we are poised for a better future. And next year, the earning per share would definitely look up. There have been some delays, but many of the customers have really felt the heat and.
New customers.
Attracting any young customers. I think we have. I need to mention that employees of less than 35 years age in Indian Bank are 35%, and most of our branch managers are in that bracket. And also, the bank itself is quite tech savvy. It encourages people to, come onto the digital platform. The loyalty of the senior customers, who are all very very strong believers in Indian Bank, is now transferring to their successive generations, and we are able to hold them. So the number of new accounts opened, at least 30 to 35% come from the younger. That is one metric we track.
NPA, what is the most corporate segment?
It has been infrastructure, corporate segment, definitely.
What about education segment, madam?
Education, as I said, the percentage looks big, but the actual quantum is low. So, and we are not, in the recent years, this is not a question of recent years, this is of some time back. And so those students have studied, now there was some restructuring in between, so now the repayments are coming due. We are trying through other channels for those recoveries.
MSME is better now?
MSME is under control, yes, it's better.
Okay. Only corporate is more?
Corporate we will resolve. Corporate, where resolutions are in sight, only we have to reach them.